Okay, let's make an inclinometer. But wait, what's an inclinometer? Let's ask our almighty Google. So an inclinometer is an instrument used for measuring angles or slopes or tilt, elevation or depression of an object with respect to Earth's gravity. So let's go to some basics. Earth on its surface pulls everything with an acceleration of 9.81 meters per second square towards itself, and this acceleration will always be perpendicular to the surface of the Earth. So we can use this fact to our advantage and calculate something known as components. The free body diagram of any body on an incline would look something like this. The knowledge of vectors and some trigonometry will tell us that the body will experience a pull of g times sine of angle of inclination along the inclined plane. Don't believe me? Let's test it. Wanna go even faster? Let's increase the angle. So our math is right. So let's look at an accelerometer. It measures acceleration, obviously. I used MPU9250IC for measuring acceleration. This was an overkill because this IC had 3 direction accelerometers, 3 axis gyroscopes and 3 axis magnetometers and a temperature sensor. So the sine of angle of inclination will be given by dividing the parallel component by the Earth's acceleration due to gravity. So let's start. Our 9250IC, a 0.96 inch OLED display as the output and an Atmel Atmega 328P in the form of Arduino Nano as the brains of the system. I took a simple square shaped wood as the base and marked two holes for mounting the IC. I clamped the wood into a plain old bench vise and drilled the hole. Mounting the IC perfectly is important as any tilt in fixture will certainly give wrong values. Once marked, I drilled two holes and fitted them with simple screws. Once I was sure that the IC fit perfectly in the holes, I cut female headers for my Arduino Nano and the OLED screen, mixed some two component adhesive and pasted them. At the end, the final chassis looks something like this. Not bad, eh? Then I fit the Arduino Nano and the OLED display and started tinning the wires and the headers. At the end, I connected all the ground wires to the ground of Arduino Nano and VCC to 5V. Both the SDA lines of the IC and the OLED display go to Arduino A4 and the SCL lines goes to A5. With this, our wiring is complete. Super easy. After this chaotic wiring, I mounted the IC one last time and our mechanical build is ready. The final look was pretty decent to my taste. Now, because the body is ready, it's time to educate the brains of the project. Here starts the difficult part, programming. At first, I googled the IC for the library. Open this GitHub link and download a zip file. After opening the IDE, I went into Sketch, Include Library, Add Zip File. Once complete, you can see some new codes in your example section. I opened Advanced I2C to pretend to be smart. After analyzing the sketch for a while and concluding that it was pretty simple, I uploaded it. After having a look at the serial monitor, I found that there was some extra work to do as the IC gave values above 11 meter per second square. This will not happen unless you are on a rocket off to International Space Station. So, after a bit of observation and some mapping, I found these functions gave acceptable values. In case you are wondering why such big values, then let me tell you that the map function only accepts integer as its input or arguments. So any values near to 0, such as 0.5, will be rounded off to its previous integer. Once that was complete and after receiving the values from the serial monitor that seemed legit, I moved on to adding the code for the display. Now I can use it to see how poorly I have set up the fridge. I hope you like this project. Don't forget to check out the instructables for this project. The link is in the description.